Yeah, let's get rid of that. Oh! Oh, no, 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 no. There we go. Bring that back in there. Alright, well, let's put everything back then. And let's go and make... How many of these pneumatic traps should we actually make? Because we actually need a shitload. I can't remember exactly how big our compound is in the desert. I suppose what we could do with to start with is just like do every other one rather than a solid bank of them, because they are damned expensive on the scrap cable front. I mean, I reckon, what do you reckon the perimeter is? It's got to be 20, 46, it's got to be at least 80. I reckon maybe 100 traps if we wanted to do a full single perimeter. I think I left the damn thing running, you know. So that's a bit of the old rotting flesh wasted there. Let's take all of this back. Awesome. I kind of like this setup. In fact, I'm pretty bloody impressed with it, actually. It looks good. Sorry, Sebastian. Have you been nom-nomming without me? You have, haven't you, cheeky little devil? Yeah, I'll try like a mix of things, like turning it all off and logging back in, or leaving them running and logging back in, turning the server off and on again. We'll just have to see if we can... it's the forged iron I need. Sorry, Sebastian. No walkies just yet, mate. How did the mining machines? They're really good, mate. We just need to change the rate at which they mine if they're going to be useful. So, for example, if you put 50 batteries in, you only get 50. You only get 50 stone out of it, which is shockingly poor, you know, return on your investment, really, mate. So, but it worked. It did definitely work. There might have been an issue with the sound following me. I'm not entirely sure, but to be honest, that wouldn't bother me. Because I wouldn't be using them like that. I'd actually have them in my mine. So what I'd be doing is, while I was mining myself, as in actually building a tunnel, I would simply also have my machines running. So I'm just getting more and more stuff all the time. I'd probably just use them for stone anyway. I suppose what you've got to take into account, and what we haven't done, is maybe we've not used the nitrate one. So say, for example, I think there's a specific mining machine for nitrate. So, of course, whereas stone you need it in the hundreds of thousands, the nitrate you don't need in quite such huge quantities. I wonder if it's the same return. Might have to play about with that a little bit. What was that? I've noticed this guy that Grump does. Oh yeah, yeah. Talking about the microphone. Yeah, if I kind of do this lot, I mean, obviously it's gonna, it just changes the volume a lot. It's just because I'm moving around, I think, Sky. Thought you mentioned it earlier, but like I said, there's no way for me to fix that short of kind of just getting better at using a standalone mic, I suppose. What's that? You need a gas generator to make the gas. No, no, no. That's this thing here, look. It's the... Oh, hang on. Is it the biofuel? Or maybe it's not in here. Hang on. I think you put plant fibres and something in it. It's a biogas digester. I can't remember, mate. I honestly can't remember. But I'm sure once you've built this, I think you need to put turds in it and some empty gas bottles and maybe some plant fiber, and it slowly fills the gas bottles. Does that make sense? The thing is, Beast, we don't know how good they are. They might be absolutely crap, mate. I just thought we'd just try them and see how they work, but... We'll certainly make like 30 or 40 of them. Let's just go and make a... Let's see if they stack first. Jesus Christ, if they don't stack, we really have got a problem. It actually means I need to create one of these Zed generators and a lathe in the desert. Yeah, right. Well, it won't be a huge pain in the ass, but... Right, he's got food. Let's turn him on. Let's make... I mean, let's make 5 and let's see if they stack. No, I don't think it should, though, Beast. I don't think it should, mate. I think you should get more stone than you would nitrate, personally. And that's certainly the way I'm going to mod it on our server. So that, like, maybe one battery will give you 10 stone. But in the nitrate machine, one battery will only give you 1 nitrate or something like that. It was turds in the video, was it, Stripe? Yeah, I'm pretty sure it was turds and something. I'm not sure whether it was plant fibre or rotting flesh. I'm not sure. I mean, Fortune had a great idea with the poop turds, with the meat stew. I'm quite excited for that. The other workaround would be to change the turd and have rotting flesh. Rotting flesh or a turd in a biogas generator? Seems reasonable to me.
Hello?
Hello? Hello, Freeze. How you doing? That's actually a very good pointer. Who's that? Lockster. Why not vanilla biofuel? That's not a bad idea at all. That is not a bad idea at all, mate. How many are we going to make, then? These are quite expensive, aren't they? Springs, we've got a fair few. Just making 10 is like 100 springs. Holy shit. Wow. God damn, mate. Shit. This mod is fucking incredible. It really is. It's really making me think about stuff, I tell you. We have got a lot of springs. What else do you need springs for? The only thing we use them for are like vault doors and hatches and things, isn't it? Just go and grab some more springs, make some more traps, and we'll get a couple of spins in tonight. Let's take some more rotting flesh. Ow. Getting through it all, aren't we? I was starting to think we should have just did it all at Caliper City. I'm starting to almost regret the desert build now. Be alright. Shit, I left it on, look. Oh, mind you, it was still manufacturing then, wasn't it? Forged iron, we're out. Gotta start remembering to turn him off if he's not actually making anything. I mean, rotting flesh is not an issue. You can easily get it, but at the same time... In fact, I tell you what, after the horde, do not let me... Yeah, we must knife them all. We've got to start actually getting the rotting flesh and the bones. It's absolutely essential to us at the moment, isn't it? Okay, forged iron. Let's make another 100 of that. Not exactly short, are we? Sorry, Dayhawk. So, Grumble, with the UK out of the Union, maybe you all can join the Trump Union and we can get cheaper flights from America and the UK. And we can finally have a Grumble does America. Yes, well, it's going to be a long time before I suppose we really see any mega changes. It's going to be a good couple of years, yeah, innit? How do I prevent Zeds from spawning in your city? I don't. To be honest, look, there's no way around that, mate. The only way I could, I mean, if I wanted to, the only way I could do it is every single block here, every single patch of road that I've not placed, I would have to put something on it or dig it up and replace it. Apparently player-made blocks they can't spawn on, but it would take me so long, mate. And then, to be honest, I quite enjoy the fact they can spawn in here. Apart from when it happens on a bloody horde night, that is a pain in the ass. Get another 7, we can make, well, I'll tell you, let's just get all... Get another 17, we can make 10 more. What's that doing? When are you going to connect the desert compound to the city? Yeah. Well, I tell you what, after the work we did on the bridge zoning, I was thinking about more of a... how can I put it? Like an elevated motorway rather than a subterranean sort of grumbutty connection. Well, what are you trying to say about Justin Bieber Day, Hort? Eh? What are you trying to say, mate? Nothing wrong with a bit of Bieberage, you know? You're not a Bieber fan, man. Should I sing you a bit of Bieber? Right, Come on, Sebastian. Oh, he's out. That's why, look. Okay, let's make another... I mean, that's 32. Jesus, that's expensive, mate. The short iron pipes and forged iron are a problem. Springs, I suppose we could say. Big issue, is it? The forged iron that I'll actually need more of. I think I'd like to go back with 50, because that would probably do two sides. You watch the first horde go on the other side, though. Hello, Senders. Thank you very much for the follow, mate. What I'm a little bit worried about is, I suppose, if at any point one of the distribution blocks, so one of the gas pipes, if at any point one of those gets damaged, the whole operation will just cease. So that's something we need to sort of bear in mind as well. I know what you're saying, to be honest, Mad Gunny. It's very tempting to just say fuck it and just keep work on Caliper City. But the point is, I don't know, mate. I'm not sure. The thought of trying to get pneumatic. I don't know. What's your thoughts in chat? I mean, what do you think? Do you think we should just scrap the desert compound and do all this work at Caliper City? Bieber's Canadian, is he? I didn't know that. Let me get you out of there so you've not got to listen to that. I've got to have a slurp of me drink. Woo! The desert is needed as a resource outpost. It is. The thing is, it's a lot easier for me to defend. Well, I say that, or is it? I mean, I don't know. I don't know how well that place would hold up to a tier 7 horde, to be quite honest. No, I know that's what you're saying, Mad Gunny. I'm just trying to figure out if anybody else feels the same way. I mean, we could. I mean, I suppose we've started work on this side with the traps. I could put, I just don't know. I mean, we could put the pneumatics in here. I suppose we could have the boilers. I don't even know where I'd put the fucking boilers, to be honest. It's so big though, mate. I just can't see it happening. Have we turned the power on yet? Not quite, mate. No, we're very close to having steam power. We've got electricity in the sense of we can power the machines. You can see old Sebastian here is working hard. Better give him a bit more rotting flesh, haven't we? Yeah, you're probably right, Strike. You're probably right, mate. I've only got 38 cloth as well. I think you ran out of fuel, didn't you, you cheeky sod? How much of this can I make? Should we just make it all? Let's make 208. Oh, what the hell? Do what? Let's stop pissing about. Let's get production going. Come on, let's go back to Sebastian. Let's get some more of this shit made. The boiler should be underground. I did think about that. The problem we've got out in the... Oh, has he stopped working? Asshole. God, dude, you are one hungry ass zombie. Nearly morning. Oh, shit, we'll do spins. Sorry. We'll do spins. Let's just take 20. Oh no, we're gonna have to take it all. This guy is like slow as hell, isn't he? See, if we got the bloody big gas generator, we'd be laughing. But I need to be able to place the mill, I think, for that, and definitely got an issue with that one. My God, I'm out of wood. You cannot make this shit up. Yeah, I think you're right, 76, to be honest. It's got, I have, you know, I'm supposed to put my tuppence in there. It is nice bouncing between the two, and sometimes it's nice. One of the bonuses we get out of it, of course, is the fact that it also helps with the respawn on the loot containers. You know, if we spend a couple of weeks away from an area and then come back, you know, It does work to our advantage, I think, to be honest, having the two sites. Still only 22, look. Need loads more forged iron. What do you reckon? I'm pretty sure one side of the desert compound is around 20 blocks. It's certainly around that, isn't it? So we definitely want at least a minimum of 80 traps if we're going to do it. Fort Bear is a holiday shack. Yeah, well, the thing is, I suppose, what we could do in between the two... maybe like you were saying earlier, it's almost making it so we've got a point of placement, makes it easier to replace these. Almost like you said, you were, you know, kind of boxing them in. And then what we could have along the middle here on top is like a little row of chests, perhaps. Sort of one full of the rotting flesh. Yada yada. Let's go and get the rest of the forged iron. Oh, sorry, let's do the spins. Let's do spins. Right, are you there, Simps? Are you okay to do these, mate, or...? Right, first up is the Jova, so good luck, mate. Oh, hang on, did I actually just pull your name out? No, it's not Jova. No, it's not Jova. Sorry, mate, you've already had your spin, didn't you? I'm not, that was from the last round. Next up is Gage. So good luck, Gage. Thanks, Simpsy. A cheeky 75, a little zunin. Next up is Fortune, who hopefully is fast asleep, resting her weary head.
Hello?
Hello. You're right, Krill. Thanks for the follow, mate. 75. Next up is the Dash. How you doing, Dash? Good luck, mate. And we'll do one more. It's the one and only Mr. Daikoi. Cheeky little zoom in. Right, let's just quickly make sure, has he actually finished making these? They've got 2 minutes to go. It's probably going to be about right, isn't it? Right, we've basically got until tonight to carry on making the traps and the pipes, haven't we? It's amazing how quick we're going to get through all of this, but... all the rest of the rotting flesh is downstairs, isn't it? I'm almost thinking, you know, you were talking about this and the boxes. I actually think we should really put some concrete around here. Because if anything was to spawn in here, we could end up with a real problem on our hands, couldn't we? Can make another 34. There's no way that has got 8 minutes worth of fuel in it. Let's go and get some rotting flesh out of the bunker. What's that, Jay? This is the PC version, mate. That would literally be all of my iron gone, but you know what? I don't really give a shit. Let's go. I think I've got a good couple of hundred rotting flesh that we've saved up down here. Quite excited to go and see if it works. I mean, after all this, I mean, you know, we might get there and hey ho presto, it simply, it does jack shit. It won't be in there. 50-50, that should do us. I wonder if the cotton's finished. Did I reset all the traps? I think I did, didn't I? Oh no, we're one down, aren't we? Throw that in there. How long have we got? We've got 7 minutes on this. So let's go and put the other trap down. Bring some more forged iron back. I suppose once tonight's out of the way, we'll actually be ready to go, won't we? I think the only thing that's worrying me is the extremely low number of exploding crossbow bolts I've got right now. They are very much the you know, how I get through the bigger hordes. That's good. We just need the cotton to go with it, don't we? Or the cloth to go with it. What's the zombies doing in the cage? They are my, currently my only source of electricity, unfortunately. You watch it, right. We made all these traps, used all these resources. We're going to get back to the bloody desert camp later on, and they're just going to be like, yeah, no, they don't work. Oh, the rage is going to be strong, I swear to God. So that's another 47. Basically makes 100 traps. We're not going to be far off it, even if we if we're not spot on. Let's start on. What were they called? The heat pipes, weren't they? So that again is forged iron and duct tape. Yeah, I think we might have enough. It's going to be a bit touch and go, I think, but. I don't know, isn't it? It's like I said, that's why I thought we'd test it. You know, it might turn out to be a fucking absolute disaster, dude, but. We'll see. Come on, forged iron. I didn't think we'd ever struggle with this. What about boiling this one up? You got any iron in you? No, you haven't. Sod you. Six in there as well, what? Definitely not balls that up, right? So the joint is a straight conversion. It's actually the joints that I'm primarily going to want. I can't really show you what I've got planned without placing a block, so I'm quite excited to get it. It's a shame we can't do it today. I genuinely got confused. I thought the horde was yesterday evening. No way, dude. We always close the doors. It's quite likely Daphne will get in here. Don't these traps need a gas system for them to light up, Grim? They need gas, don't they? No, not the spike traps. They're essentially steam. That's why we've created the two boilers. Oh, talking of which, actually, I need to make the other two boilers. We are going to need them. There's no way around it. Which is the brass, wasn't it? Let's, the other glue there. I'll tell you what, let's start off with some more duct tape. Knock that lot out. Can I actually make two boilers? I think I just can with the brass. I need 50, I've got 109, so we're okay. So gain more forged iron. Jesus Christ. I'll tell you what, neither did I, Zunin. Neither did I, mate. I mean, jeez. We're really getting through it. Do I have a motorbike in the tank? I do, yeah. In fact, we've got a couple of motorbikes kicking about. Tell you what I'm going to do, because we don't need any of this stuff on us anyway, right? So let's just put all of this away for now. And let's just... how long was left on the... So if I don't close that door and Daphne spawns in, then she could potentially destroy my forges. And if my forges were to go down, I'd be fucked. The amount of resources sitting in those forges, quite frankly, is ridiculous. Is he going to keep running for long enough? Come on, Sebastian. Get more efficient, dude. We've still got 31-ish to make. Yeah, all right. I'm happy with that. Is there anything else you can think of? When we get back, all we need is pipes and the traps. We've got the boilers, we've got the pipes, we've got the traps. We can convert to... One thing we are going to need are valves. Now, I reckon we're going to need in the region of... We're probably going to need between 4 and 5 per side. So I honestly think we're probably going to need 20 of those. As long as we take enough springs. I mean, it's only 40 springs. And the forged iron and the pipes shouldn't be an issue. So, I don't think we need to worry about that just yet. Like I said, you can't expand the... if you like, the energy distribution blocks beyond 10 without putting a valve in. And I think I'm probably going to take them a maximum of 8 just to err on the side of caution. Do I not make another boiler? Thank you. I swear I clicked two. Let's put all this back then. Shall we very quickly go to the mine and make... Hang on, I'll tell you what we'll do. Because it's going to drive me mad if I don't. I need to find 71 feathers. Exploding crossbow bolts. I don't think we've got enough gunpowder, to be honest. But 71 feathers would do it. Let's go feather searching. You're right, don't suck. How are you, mate? What I'm worried about is going too far. I wonder if the generator will stop running. Welcome back, Super C! I think I need to get a coffee, Super C. Yeah, we'll be best going out of town, won't we? This is not the best place to be looking for birds' nests, is it really? Eight, that's a good start. I think the burnt area is better. As long as I don't sort of like set fire to myself, hello? We might have a bit more luck. Hello! Cheers, Steve! Thank you very much for the follow, mate. It's only 9:15 in the morning on the Horde day. Got hours to kill. Grump, Derek, Inks and Bomber had spins last time, so Jova is due a spin. That's impossible, mate. Really? Do you want me to do it? I'll tell you what, if you've made the decision, Simpsy, we shall do him a spin. Here we go. Good luck, Jova. GZ Jova, GZ, thank you, Simpsy. Sorry, I don't want to cheat anyone. My bad. I should have given you level 2, Jova. Yes, it's definitely easier here than in the sort of like the woody area. Should we start heading towards that? Airdrop. So that has a bit of a point of reference. So what is that? We try and sort of keep W with the 7. Look at the Irish. They are actually quite hard to see even here, to be fair. Oh, really? I can walk over these, yeah? Yeah. I don't think entirely sure which ones. Sort of, I take it it's these that are look more like an abandoned campfire, the ones that will make me burst into flame. Don't need it, but I'll take it, mate. Oh, look at that. 3 bird's nests. Sweet! Well, we've nearly got enough. That's another 71 exploding arrows, if I've got enough gunpowder, which I don't think I have, but every little helps. Every little. I always work on the assumption that a Horde knight, absolute bare minimum, probably 50 exploding crossbow bolts. If the shit really starts going down, especially tier 7, I reckon we need to double that. This is a nightmare. See, squat. Two. Shocking. at 7, that's a bit bad. I think that's actually enough, but I don't have any of the gunpowder on me, so... Shall we just carry on, just say until about 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock in game time? Because we seem to be getting a nice stash of feathers out of it, don't we? And we are very low on them. I do quite like the sound of the chicken coop mod, just to be able to get a slightly easier source of feathers. But I'm not sure just exactly how much of an investment you have to put into that mod to keep that happening. It might be just as quick just to get out and scavenge for the damn things. You never know, do you? Don't seem to be finding any birds' nests. I keep thinking these things are the lot. If you get them at the right angle, it just looks like a bit of a bird's nest out in the distance. Hello, Mr. Birdie. We need some chocobos. That's what we need. We've got pigs and we've got deers. Now we need to add in some chocobos. Give you a good, what, say 200 feathers from a chocobo? I'd be up for that. What do you reckon? Should we mod one in? Feather problem solved. Sinks. Where am I going to get sinks out here, dude? These? Don't I need, I can't do anything with that. Well, I can smash it, but... Not sure what you mean by sinks, mate. Well, I know what you mean by sinks, but I don't know where they're all at here. Hang on, I'll tell you what, let's start heading home. At least heading in that direction. Yeah, as soon as we get a little bit away from here and back to Caliper City, I'm going to take just a 2-minute break, just grab myself a nice fresh coffee. Then hopefully have a guzzle on that and we'll be ready for the horde. And then as soon as the horde's done, we're actually ready to go and start these pneumatic traps. I really hope they're not an anti-climax, folks. I can only apologise if it is. Like I said, I've not, you know, I don't know anything about them, really. There's one thing that I do need to find out. I need to find out when we place the boiler, whether or not we can put the gas pipes underneath the boiler, or if they have to be like at the same level as it. So we might have to... I suppose we might have to almost sacrifice a boiler. Or should we just go into creative mode and do a test? That's probably the best bet, isn't it? And then everyone on the server will know how placement works with those. Get it right, we'll just ditch one of our own on the floor so we're not cheating. Steady on. Has anyone heard when this bloody Pokemon Go is actually going to hit England then, or the UK? Have we actually got a date, or is it at the moment, is it just you'll get it when it suits us and all the other servers are happy? I really wanted to have a play about with that at the weekend. There's a Grumbodian server plot marker. Jesus Christ. It's been a long time since we were out here, innit? I remember building that thing. That was one of the first ones, wasn't it, I think? I think these are definitely the best zone. I think that and the snow biome for feathers seem to be... Ooh, check this puppy out, look. Nice! Very nice. Sitting there. Ripe for the plucking. shit, that's not a bear, is it? Jesus Christ, I proper started bricking it then. Can you imagine a bear coming out and killing me? Oh my God. I should have brought the bike, shouldn't I? We'd have been on and off it too often. That sounds very close, whatever that is. See ya. Like a fucking sonar here. Flip. Bird's nests, that's all we're after. How we doing? 155, that is not bad. That is not bad at all. God damn you. Not so worried about the bacon and eggs anymore, because we could get the meat stew is so much easier for us to make anyway, isn't it? And I think it actually gives us more wellness than bacon and eggs anyway, which is a bit shocking, really. There's the digger, look. We'll go down here, hang a left, and that we're pretty much back home then, aren't we? That went all right, to be honest. I actually didn't think we'd get that many feathers, to be fair. I'll tell you what about a mod, an interesting mod? What about a mod whereby you could actually either craft birds' nests, maybe. Put them up on a roof on a building. Something like that, I don't know. You got to be careful you don't make the game too easy, but... Probably a good job we're all spread out a little bit, isn't it? Otherwise we'd all be fighting over the same little pool of feather resources. What's that, Sammy? hang on, was that the game that was raffled? I mean, they used a couple and I was a bit AFK, so I don't remember the exact name. Time Mysteries 2 was the one that was raffled, yeah. Yeah, that's it, Advina, you've got it, mate. can someone explain how to make reinforced concrete? I can, mate, just bear with me. So this is reinforced concrete, what you're looking at here, yeah? And the way you start that, let me walk you through it just really quickly, mate. I'm not going to actually oh, I can hear Daphne. Oh no, I'll tell you what, it's probably the zombie. Oh shit. I think we've caught a Z. Oh, we have caught a Z. Hang on. Let's take another cage out. So, to make reinforced concrete, first thing you need to make is this stuff, mate. Rebar. So that's just like a... And you can do that in the forge. So, to make rebar, you basically need iron and clay. And then all you do is you put that down like a normal block. Then you need wood and concrete. Obviously, wood as in just normal wood. And concrete, which is this concrete mix. But to make the concrete mix, you need a cement mixer. We've made any actually, and you need to mix two parts stone with one part cement and one part sand in the cement mixer. So if I take 2,000 stone, 1,000 sand, and 999 cement, you bastard, I can go into the cement mixer, click concrete, craft it up. Bish bash bosh. Super easy. Easy, but very time consuming. Very, very time consuming. Here's all my rebar. Okay, so birds' nests can come back. Schematics, I don't give a shit about beakers, they can just go. Let's go and capture, let's go and get our Z. Gonna get out of the cage down, get the other Z, then we'll go and get the gunpowder and start making the exploding crossbow bolts. We should be just about pretty much done for the day then, shouldn't we, really?
Hello?
Hello? You're right, Colston, how you doing, mate? Might have to repair some of that razor wire at some point. That's weird, like I can't actually see a Z in the cage. Ah shit, what's happened there then? Well, that's weird. I don't want to bait it. What the fuck's happened there, dude? This one we knew got damaged, so I think we might have to smash that one over there and reset it. I think it's tried to catch a zombie and maybe the zombie's despawned or something. So I don't want to bait it, although it literally will actually attract zombies, and that's not really something I want to be doing right now. Do you think it's possible to turn Caliper City into steel and put... Yeah, I'm sure we could, Mad. I'm not a big fan of the aesthetic of the steel, to be honest, mate. Right, we've got 100 spike traps there. Oh my god, there's two of them in the fucking cage! What the fuck? Holy shit! Sebastian's had a baby. What the fuck, Sebastian? Really, dude? You know what's happened, don't you? That zombie over there that's in that trap is actually somehow coming to the zombie generator. Look at them. It looks like they're having fun. You all right, boys? Oh, dearie me. How's about that, eh? Equal rights for everyone, including the zombies, right? Let's go put the boiler and everything away, and then we should... basically, as soon as the horde's done, I essentially want to nail-gun the crap out of Caliper Sea, get her up and running. I want her to be straight to the desert tomorrow morning. You know, I'm talking about, like, straight away. No pissing about. Sorry, actually, I didn't mean to do that. Damn, I needed Hello? That for the... Hello. Take those. Let's put these back then. That can come downstairs with me. Let's go and get the gunpowder. Thank you very much for the follow, Keegan. How are you, mate? You all right, Elegon? How are you doing? Elegon, we've got a problem. We've got a definite problem. All the power stuff seems to essentially stop working. Not sure whether it's when you log out or whether it's... because of the server reboot. Right, medical stash. All these can go back in there. That was quite good finding those airdrops, wasn't it? It's worked out quite well for us. Schematic, schematic, schematic. Gunpowder's over here. How many can I make? 49 before I run out of gunpowder. So it's just nitrate that's slowing me down. I take some coal with me. Should we go and hit the mine? It's 325. If we're really quick. Oh, mind you, I really want a coffee, mate. Just be nice to get a little bit of nitrate, wouldn't it? Can't remember where I put the bike. Is she in here? Let's go to the quarry really quick. I think it's that one, isn't it? Oh, actually. thinking about it, we don't need to go all the way to the quarry, do we? We've got that lovely mine that we've started. Oh, you know what we should have done? We should have brought the mobile spotlight. Where the hell is it? Hey, what's going on here? Where's my... where's my cave? Well, that's just plain weird. What's going on here, guys? Oh, hang on. Is that Grumbutty Junction? Oh, it is. Sorry. I'm not nowhere near it, am I? That's why. Oh! I'll tell you what. Let's park at the quarry. Pickaxe is okay. What's that mojo? You grooming it? I want me to log in so you can log out and see if it continues to work. I'm gonna test it later, Elegon, rather than doing it on the stream. There's a few things we need to check. We need to check whether or not it's me. You know, if I place... put it in terms of the Zed generators, Elegon. When I tried to get them to start walking by putting the flesh in there. I put the flesh in. They're just not interested. They're not doing anything. Very similar to what happened with the batteries in the wind turbine yesterday. Day before. So... one of two things. It's either happening after a server reset or it's happening whenever I log out. So a couple of things for us to test, but more importantly, we need to find a way to reboot the items. Because obviously having to... The only way I've fixed it today, Elegon, is to literally smash them, rebuild them and replace them. And that is not a viable workaround. What's that? Who's Graham? I ain't got a clue. Who's Graham? Is there even anyone in chat called Graham? No idea, Simpsy. What's that? Give me some bloody nitrate, mate. Do you have every skill maxed out? Nowhere near, mate. Nowhere near. I mean, I'm only level 101. It's just such slow progress now. I've got the ones that I care about pretty much maxed. But there's a lot of things that, you know, I don't really spend much time doing. You know, like armor smithing. We've still not done any fishing yet. That's still really low. No idea, Keedflay. No idea, mate. How long did you wait after putting the flesh in? Ages, dude. Ages. We didn't put it in, out. We shook it all about. We did the umbongo, the drink it in the Congo and everything. It weren't having it, Elegon. It just was not having it. Exactly. Remember yesterday? Oh, sorry. Monday. With the wind generator where it just stopped working. The weird thing is, Elegon, it's everything. It's not just the Zed generators. It's also the wind turbine and it's also the mining machine. So essentially everything that's connected to the power mod, it looks like it's still there and it's still accessible. And to all intents and purposes, it looks fully functional, but it just doesn't actually provide power or function. Sorry, who was that? I just missed that. Hello, Morphone. Hello, you do? How you doing, mate? Thank you for the follow, dude. Oh. Whoa. 25 gunpowder. That's all I've got so far. Oh, yeah, because we're still making that. Oh, sorry. My bad. Who is Crumb? What? That was a text error. I meant to say Crumb. So far, Mad Gunny, you've called me everything but Grum. So I've now become Graham Crum. Surely it's not that hard, mate. Hello, hello, hello. It's a bit better than Yabba Dabba Doo, isn't it? I like the Yabba Dabba Doo, but Yabba Dabba Doo only ever happened like once in a while. Just call me Graham Theodore Crum is my real name, apparently. Wow. Shocking, shocking. It's just terrible, mate. How you doing, Keegan? Yeah, come and join us on Discord. Actually, you know what? I'll put another raffle up. In fact, let's do another raffle now. Give me 60 seconds. One sec. There you go. There's a raffle for a game called Surviving Space, which has been donated by Dolphin. Thank you very much, Dolphin. Much appreciated. You will need to still be in chat in approximately 5 to 7 minutes, which is when the raffle alarm will go off. If it doesn't go off in the next 10 minutes, then remind me. It means something's gone wrong. Like I forgot to press start. which is normally the reason. Graham Crumb. I've been called a few things since, so I've never been called Graham Crumb before. Blimey. So we got, I thought we were going to find a nice little node of nitrate there. Oh, we still might be onto something. You're right, NV, how are you? Only we could get brass so easily as lead, right? God damn it. The Grub Norton. He's a funny guy, he is. Old Graham Norton. I've missed way too many of his shows. I really have. They're always on at a really like crappy time. I'm just not, I suppose I'm just not a TV kind of person, but how's things then, Envy? What have you been up to, mate? You got 7 days to die? You're hitting it hard? Gotta be careful I don't double back down our main tunnel or it's gonna look really weird. Is that just like one at a time now, look? 7 o'clock, we're out of here. We're gonna head straight. In fact, I'll tell you what, I might even get a chance to get a coffee if we go now, so. Come on, where's the way out? Way out, oh shit, way out? Oh, hang on a minute. What's happened here? Oh God, hang on. There it is, don't panic. I couldn't find the orifice. Major, I think there was an error on your golden grumbombs, by the way, so I did sort it out earlier. I think technically you've got 12 golden grumbombs, so I did change it on the command. Remember the number of times the bike fell down there until we backfilled it? I was like, oh my God, every time I tried to turn around in this bit. Love this tunnel. Absolutely love it. Can't wait till everything's networked like that. I don't think we need anything, do we? I think I'll just put the duct tape and stuff back. Oh, we're on 248. We're nearly at 250 wellness again. Thank God for that. Which one did we shove it all in? Right, I'll put the duct tape, the arrowheads, and the feathers, because we can take all of that with us, can't we? We must... Oh, the boilers have stacked. Ah, fantastic. Oh, that's a result. Okay. Right, let's go and get ready for the horde. And if I'm really lucky... Who's on the server? Oh, bomber! Bomber's done a runner. Come on. Back to Bunker Bob for a horde. I'm quite excited. I wonder if we'll get it. We'll get it. It's going to be a T1. It's going to spawn inside the Grum Pyramid, and I'm just going to sit here wailing. Okay. Home sweet home. So what we'll do, we'll take these three. We're definitely going to take the pickaxe, and we're definitely going to take the hunting knife, purely because we want to get the bones. So we'll put the hammer and the shovel away. Pop these on the toolbar. Get off that, mate. Get off that. I do not want you blowing yourself up. Lump of coal could go back. Don't need any of this shit, but we'll leave it on us. Because we haven't got time. Got a bit of gunpowder.
Hello.
And we need the ammo. Hello! Magnum rounds. We'll take another 30 of those just in case it really goes to shit. Thank you very much for the follow there, Rich Airplane. We'll take some more 7.62 rounds. Right, that's us pretty much sorted. Shall I... No, let's not. All right, it's going to be 10 o'clock. I'm going to really quickly get a coffee, folks. I'll be straight back. And at 10 o'clock tonight is the horde, so...
Hello? Hello?
Just saw the Raffles alarm's gone off. Just let me sort this out then. So, this was a raffle for a game called Surviving Space. It's a Steam code or a Steam gift, which is coming through to you by a gentleman called Dolphin. So thank you very, very much, Dolphin. We've got Beast Runner, Zunin, Rans, Demons, 76, Daniel, Colston, Keegan, Blackberry, and Advina are all in. So I'm going to pull a name out of the hat. If your name is pulled out, you need to type exclamation mark claim in chat. If you type exclamation mark claim in chat and it's not your name, you will be banned. So please don't do it. And the winner is... Blackberry. Or Blackberry, is that? I'm not sure. Blackberry? Black, congratulations, mate. Well done. So you are now the proud owner of a Surviving Space. You just need to type exclamation mark claim in chat now. If you don't, you've got about 60 seconds to do it, mate. If you don't, I'll pull another name out of the hat. Nice one. Cheers, Black. Alright, come on. Horde time. Horde time. Let's have a look who's on the server now. Oh, Mojo! Mojo! Mojo's horde logged, you cheeky chappy. Right, you just need to jump into our Discord channel now, Blackberry. So if you do exclamation mark Discord in chat, that'll give you a link. Jump onto our Discord channel. Go to the Prizes Galore forum and just shout out in there and we'll get you the game. Right, 5 minutes till Horde Night. Here we go. You're ready on Discord, are you? Fantastic, mate. Just type Discord and you'll get a link to ours, mate. Mojo stream logged. Oh dear, mate. Shocking. Shocking, Mojo. Shocking. I can't hear anything. Should we go? Should we go?